Hello students, welcome to our KEM ENEA channel. Through my long teaching experience, I have seen that you always have some problem regarding your topic or chapter. In my channel, I have just tried to solve your problems. Hope you will enjoy this video. Please like it, share it and subscribe the channel. Thank you very much. Welcome students, welcome to our KEM ENEA channel. Today I will teach you about the metal and non-metal. The chapter is both present in the CBSE and ICSE class 10. So this chapter will help you both the CBSE and the ICSE students. So this chapter will include you to give you the brief explanation of the metals. Our first question is, what are metals? The metals are actually elements that can conduct electricity. That's the point. But some of non-metals also can conduct electricity, but that is the exception. The metals are generally elements that can conduct electricity. And metals are by far the largest of the three classes. Actually, we have three classes of elements: metals, non-metals, and metalloids. But actually, metals are the largest number of elements that are present in the periodic table. And we have 118 elements, and most of them are metals. Now we have the metals. All of the elements on the left side, that is left side, is group 1 and group 2 is the left side. All of the elements of group 1 and 2, and in the middle, that is the called transition elements. These are also metals. So in the left hand side and in the middle, they all are elements. And also in the bottom of the periodic table, there are lanthanides and actinides. These are also metals. So we have a huge category of metal, huge numbers, not categories, the number of metals. Now group 1, there are several different types of metals, including alkali metals. These are group 1 is called alkali metals of the periodic table, and alkaline earth metal. Group 2 is the alkaline earth metal, and the transition metal is the metals which have property in between these metals and these elements and these elements. That's why they are called transition elements. And lanthanides are all metals and are similar to their reactivity to the group 2, that is beryllium, magnesium, calcium, having the property. And actinides having typical metals and the properties both D block and A block elements. Here I will say one thing, that some of the points here we are discussing is not in your book. So those are extra points I'm discussing here. Now the properties of metals. Metals here, they are very hard. Hardness, the most of the metals are hard, except alkali metals. Actually, metals are closely packed structures. That's why they are so hard. But alkali metals are soft in nature, such as sodium, potassium. We can cut them by knife. So their hardness is quite low. Why the metals are so hard? Because of the closely packed structures, and also because of their metallic bonding. The metallic bonding is poor in sodium and potassium, but is very strong for the other metals like iron. What are metallic bonding? Metallic bonding is nothing but metals can reject their valence electrons in their surroundings and forms a positive charged spaces called kernel. And this kernel and the electrons having electrostatic force of attraction, giving the metallic bonding and creating the metallic bonding. So metallic bonding is nothing but the electrostatic force of attraction between the kernel and the electrons. So those metals which are hard, metallic bonding is very harder, and which are being soft, metallic bonding is weaker. The less metallic bonding is due to the fact that the less number of electrons are contributed in the metallic bonding for sodium, potassium, etc., because they have the last shell, they have in their last shell one electron strength. Most of the metals are strong and of high tensile strength. That is also due to their metallic bonding. They are very strong and they are high tensile strength. Metals are solid at room temperature except mercury. Mercury is a liquid. Mercury having melting point in the negative degree centigrade. That means in the lower than 0 degree centigrade. Sound. That is the point. Metals are sonorous. Why metals are sonorous? We heard sometimes the metals are sonorous. If we hit the metals, they give a sonorous sound. But why they are so sonorous? Why they make sound? When the metal is hit, a compressive wave result. This wave moves through the metal until it hits another surface. So this wave moves through the metal until it hits another surface, and that is the reflection of sound waves causing the sound. It then reflects from the surface and continues, and this reflection continues until and unless these waves having energy zero, energy falls to zero. So that's why formation of wave and hitting the surface, this wave causing the sonorous sound for the metal. The velocity of the sound inversely proportional to their density, or that light materials carry sound vibrations better than the tense and heavy objects. That means conduction. Conduction, metals, we know metals are good conductor of heat and electricity. Now the question is, why the metals are good conductor of heat and electricity? First, come to the point for heat. Now for heat, the heat passes when we heat some material, some metal, the atom get excited, they get the heat energy and they starts to vibrate. These vibration, as they close the pack, these vibration spreads over all the metals. And also when we heat, the free electrons present, we have already discussed, the free electrons present in the metals absorb this heat, and they also moves faster, and during this that their movement, they can collide with the other electrons and also the metallic atoms. So they get resistance, and we know that resistance in a metal causes the heat producing. So there are two points, one vibration of atoms and another movement of electrons causing collisions between the electrons and the metallic atom and giving the and producing the heat. And the movement of the free electrons. So this is the cause that the electric wires are made of metals like copper and aluminium. Malleability. We know what is malleability. Malleability is nothing but to hammer a metal to make it shed. That is the malleability. And what is ductility? And to hammer a metal to make it the thin wire, that is the ductility. So our question is, why the metals having the malleability and ductility properties? The malleability and ductility property is due to their on hammering atomic planes. This is the point. On hammering, atomic planes glide over each other. As they glide over each other, we can hammer the metal to make it malleable and to make it ductile. Next, the melting point and boiling point. The melting point depends on the metallic bonding. That's so strong, the metallic bonding. So how are the melting point? Generally, group 1 alkali metals having low melting point due to their large size, and down the group, melting point becomes much lower due to further increase in size. So for the alkali metals, the melting point is low. The melting point is lower. There's one point that the lower melting point of group 1 alkali metal is due to having only 1 electrons in the valence shell. Their contribution to the metallic bonding is very less. That is a point. And also their size is very larger due to their large size, and down the group melting point becomes much lower due to a further increase in size. That is also a point. Cesium is the lowest melting point among the alkali metal. As the size increase, that is the point, metallic bonding becomes also weaker. Mercury has the lowest melting point among the metals, and in fact it is liquid at room temperature. This is also due to the poor metallic bonding density. Most of the metals have a high density because they are closely packed, their volume is very less, but their mass is very high, so having density is higher. Now, another point is the shininess. Why the metals are shiny? They reflect light from the surface. The free electrons, metals are generally shiny. This is because they reflect the much of the light that strikes them. The free electrons in the metal surface absorb the visible light and emit the complementary color. But the sodium is a non-lustrous because to the formation of an oxide layer. In some of the metals, there is an oxide layer like sodium, aluminium, but the sodium is non-lustrous due to the having oxide layer on its surface. Now the fact is the defining characteristics of metal is their ability to conduct electricity. So why do you think metals have this property? Why do they conduct the electricity? Because I've already told you the electrons are in the valence shell, electrons of metals are lost, they are free electrons and they can't conduct the electricity. And that is the point. The properties, these properties, the properties of metals depends on the number and the arrangement of their electrons. This is the point. The properties of the metals, the properties of not only metals, the elements depends on number and the arrangement of the electrons. So for example, we have a lithium metal. It has in the K shell there are 2 electrons and in the L shell there is a 1 electrons. So it can easily lose its 1 electrons and give and can contribute to the metallic bonding these electrons, and that electrons is responsible. They have so many electrons, million electrons are coming from million lithium atoms and causing the heat carrying conductance, a heat carrying property, heat conductance property, or electricity conductance property of metals. So this is a summary. Metals can conduct electricity. All metals except mercury are solid. Electricity is a flow of electrons. These are summary of the metallic properties that we have already discussed. So difference between metals and non-metals, that is the point. What is the difference between the metals and non-metals? Metals, they have lustres, but non-metals, they are non-lustres. Metals are ductile, they are non-ductile. Ductile metal exception, there's a zinc. Zinc is not a ductile metal. They are malleable. Non-metals are non-malleable. Exception, they are malleable. Zinc also is non-malleable. Because is the it has a very it has a poor metallic bonding, conduct heat and electricity, poor conductor of heat and electricity. That is, there is the exceptions for graphite, that is a good conductor of heat and electricity, and diamond is also a good conductor of heat, not electricity, is good heat. And metal, these are all physical properties. These are all differences in depending on the physical properties of between metals and non-metals. They are sonorous, they are not sonorous. And the chemical properties, metal displaces hydrogen from water, they react with water to form hydrogen. And non-metals do not displace hydrogen from water. Metals are basic oxides, non-metals are acidic oxides. Metals displace hydrogen from dilute acids, but metals cannot displace hydrogen from the nitric acid, because nitric acid is an oxidizing agent. In further video we'll discuss, nitric acid is an oxidizing agent that can oxidize the hydrogen form. That's why nitric acid is not used for the formation of hydrogen from the metal. Non-metal displaces hydrogen from dilute acid. Metals form ionic chlorides, non-metals from covalent chloride. That's all for the first video for the introduction of metal and non-metal. In the next video we will discuss about the chemical properties of metals and non-metals. Till then, I think you will like the video, and if you like the video, please share it, subscribe it, and like it. Till then, thank you.